Coach Krim, as you used to always say, it's a marathon. It's not a sprint. They're about a third of the way through the marathon for both teams.
Schulte versus Noko. Opening tap controlled by Clemson in the home white uniforms. Underway in Greenville. And down low, Noko doesn't get the bounce. Rebound controlled by Marvin Smith.
Said this for years and years. It's an easier shot. Bank the ball. You have great position. Just throw it off the glass. You miss it, it'll probably come right back to you. It's not cool, but it's effective.
Tigers open up. Man-to-man defense. They'll send it down low. Five to shoot. Schulte. And a deep three from the left wing. In and out. Blossom game with the rebound. That's what he does best. Over seven per contest.
Talked about Coach Brownell's defense. That's what he wanted. 30 to 28 and a half seconds. They missed the shot and you got the rebound. That's perfect.
Nate Spartan's in a 2-3 matchup zone.
That's what they play mostly. Sometimes they follow you through. Sometimes they don't. You got to read it. Not two of the greatest shots to start for the Tigers.
Still scoreless. More than a minute in. Tigers are a little bit road weary, having tripped to Las Vegas and Minnesota in the last week.
My coach told us the kids got home and into bed about 5 o'clock in the morning. Had to get up for 8 o'clock classes the other day. So we didn't practice. Just let them rest. Told them to take a nap. How many times in college you have to be told to take a nap? Never.
We'll send it down low. Now back out. Cunningham. Comes up short. Blossom game. His second board.
A lot of times in this matchup zone, Roy, if you can beat it down the floor, you don't have to play against it. That was a good shot. He didn't make it.
Noko, the jump hook. Off target. Both of these teams will get after you defensively.
Upstate sets a lot of ball screens like that, and you just got to fight through them because they don't allow you to have space unless you make your own space.
Swinging around the horn. Baseline three short. Avery Holmes, a transfer from USF at San Francisco. Clears a rebound, and here's Roper. Inside and out. That's the way to work against that zone inside the Blossom game for the first points of the contest.
Noko gets it right in the middle of the zone. The defense has to collapse, and Blossom game just seals his man up. That's really good execution. Defense wasn't really set because they got a little bit of a secondary transition.
And here's a turnover. Nate, curious to get your thoughts on Blossom game and whether or not he's got a chance maybe to be an all-conference performer. That's five in white. We'll send it down low to Noko again. Off. Well, make that not off the glass. Sends it down. Noko is first points, and it's 4-0. But Blossom game, give me your thoughts on his potential this year.
Great athlete who needs to take the role on of being the man on this team. If he does that, I think he's capable of scoring in big numbers. He needs help, but I think he could be a very good player, one of the best in this league.
Ask it, Josh Cuthbertson. 38% from distance this year, and Upstate on the board.
Roy, the problem with being the best in this league is you got to be really good to be the best in this league because there's some great players in the ACC.
We saw that last night, North Carolina and Maryland. Tar Heels preseason ranked number one. Think about Duke, the defending national champions. Miami's off to a red-hot start. Grantham the miss, but the putback by Blossom game. 4 points, 3 rebounds already in the early going.
And that's the other thing he does. Yes, he can score, and he's really good at that mid-range game, but he gets him on the glass, and he gets offensive rebounds and just pads the stat sheet. He's a decent free-throw shooter as well.
Cunningham from 17, short. Roper the board. Quickly ahead to Blossom game with the jam and 6 early points for Jerron Blossom game, the junior from Alpharetta, Georgia.
Oh, by the way, he's not a bad athlete. He's got all the tools. He really does. He has all the tools. He's got the work ethic. He's definitely faced adversity in his career physically, and he's come back from all that.
8-3 Tigers. Cuthbertson short.
Everybody's a little tired. We haven't had a timeout yet. Or a foul.
You're not talking about the announcers now, are you?
No. Okay. I'm still good for another 20 seconds.
Blossom game to miss. And here comes USC Upstate, Mike Cunningham.
Pretty smart by Schulte. He knew he couldn't rebound. He just tipped it to Cunningham.
Spartans trailing by 5. 18 to shoot.
Clemson's not going to give you an uncontested shot. If they do, you're not going to play much longer. You're going to get contested shots. You're going to get tough defense. It's exactly what they've done so far.
Cunningham, an air ball from distance. Out of bounds, and that'll be our first time out.
Fatigue, being 4 feet instead of three, will open up the game a bit. The best rule is that you only have 10 seconds to bring it up, period. Defense plays their butt off and knocks it out of bounds. You don't get 10 more. That's the best rule. But I think the other thing, the game's evolving a little bit, but I don't think it's changing the game. I think it's better. A little.
10 to shoot. Gabe DeVoe checks in for the first time for the Tigers. As they try to send it down low, it's out of bounds. It'll stay with Clemson. Tigers dominant in the paint with 8 early points. And the Spartans still in search of their first points down low.
Here's the thing where Clemson's really good at. Out of bounds under plays. A lot of teams, though, just throw it in bounds. But they usually get something very productive out of it. And it's all called from the bench, but they're usually really good at it.
Whoa. Roper shoots it out of bounds.
End of a shot clock. He had to put it up quick. He knew it. He just couldn't hit anything. The other thing Coach Brownell's done, just put somebody in the backcourt, just put a little pressure, especially on Spana, freshman point guard.
We think back to Rod Hall as a jammer operating in that very same role. He was very disruptive for a number of years. Tristan Thompson in the contest for the first time for the Spartans, rejected by Blossom Gang. And saved beautifully by DeVoe.
Brown's done about everything tonight. Rebound, score, block shots.
8-3, just over 6 minutes in.
The one thing I think this team is missing so far, and it can happen, and there's nothing they can do about it, is the Rod Hall just relentless, get to the rim when they needed to, make something happen when they needed to. We talked about Blossom Game's offense. That's pretty good defense right there. Blocks it with the proper hand, keeps it inbounds. But they need that Rod Hall kind of a guy. He's not coming back, like what Patino said. Larry Bird's not walking through that door. Rod Hall's not coming back. But somebody can take over that role.
DeVoe coughs it up. Spartans with numbers. Jury Spahn leading the fast break. Three-pointer too strong by Thomas.
Which Payne told us, Thomas is a streaky shooter, good and bad. He can miss five in a row. He can also make five in a row. A great stroke.
I'll send it down low. You can in the hoop. 8-5.
It's a big body, Michael Buchanan, inside. Question is, can he get up and down 94 feet? Which sees you tell you in there now, and then Noko later. Played a lot last year, not playing as much this year. Buchanan.
Looking against the matchup zone. Roper, an open look, and down it goes. Coming off a career-high 25. And shooting 36% from distance.
You know what's really good about that, Roy? He airballed the last. Just put it up again. He's got confidence in his own shot. Worst thing you do is lose your confidence. He's got it back after a not good shooting start of the season.
Spartans back to work. Down low to Buchanan. Junior from Las Vegas.
Any starts last year, only a couple this year. But if he keeps doing that, he's going to get more PT. As the man with my kind of haircut likes to say.
Spartans back within 4. Blossom Game, the runner. Has a good mid-range shot. Perhaps that's not his best opportunity there.
The only thing to do is pull up and go over the defense. He's got a size advantage on whoever for the Upstate team is guarding him.
Fade away by Smith. Back iron. Blossom Game, his 4th rebound. DeVoe has a pretty good outside shot. Ty Hudson also in for the first time, a freshman. And a blocking foul down low against Buchanan, his first. 11-31.
They're scoring more points, as we talked about earlier.
Much more efficient offensively this year, the Tigers. They send it outside to Hudson.
Same matchup zone. Communication is what makes this Spartan defense work. Clemson's got, just got to keep the momentum. Can't get it stuck.
Roper is a zone buster.
Andrew Noko just screened the top man in the zone, and nobody near him. He hit 2 in a row. Confidence. Consecutive made threes.
14-7. Tigers with their largest advantage so far tonight. Clemson's been in a man-to-man. Outside to Moore for three. Count it. Big basket for Malik Moore, the freshman from Asheville, North Carolina.
Spartans did a good job of moving the basketball and got it back to Moore when the defense was not in his face. Everybody likes that shot for Clemson. We'll shoot it from that great ring.
It's a big basket trailing by seven in the early going.
You get just single digits, they got the two possessions.
DeVoe trapped up top. Here's Hudson. Four-star prospect, according to ESPN.com, a year ago. A big hoop there.
Love lefties. You're just not used to guarding somebody that's left-handed. They have a natural advantage in the game of basketball. Most lefties, too, are either really good shooters or horrendously bad shooters.
Why is that?
I don't know. Hudson's a good one, though, and so is, obviously, Jordan Roper.
Buchanan back to work against Noko. That's a great matchup in Buchanan. A couple of early baskets.
Big body, 250 pounds. Landry Noko is no lightweight, but Landry Noko does not want to commit that first foul because he's probably going to sit if he does.
Buchanan now with six. The lead is five.
Keep it moving. Let the zone mess up. They didn't that time. Good snap away. Slap away.
Second turnover by DeVoe off the Clemson bench.
There's the ball screen.
Spawn in the paint. Too strong. Buchanan has it stripped. And Jordan Roper comes out of there with a basketball. Now the one difference perhaps for these Tigers this year, the three-point shooting has been much more consistent. And of course you get the bounce when you're shooting the basketball well. Hudson now with six.
Absolutely right. The guys that shoot 31% do not make that shot. The guys that shoot in the upper percentages, they get the bounce. He's a special player. He just didn't get a lot of chance to play last year. He could be really good.
Buchanan off his knee, out of bounds.
He could be the Rod Hall type, too. He's got the body like Rod Hall. Speaking of Hudson.
Hudson stays in as Avery Holmes checks back in for Roper. Gabe DeVoe back to the bench.
It's funny. And you just hit 2-3, don't go near the bench. Don't let him get a chance to
stay away.
Absolutely, stay away. Coach, I'm good, I'm good.
Eight-point lead for the Tigers out of the ACC against USC Upstate out of the A-Sun. The Atlantic Sun has had a couple of good runs in the NCAA tournament in recent years.
Absolutely.
Going back to Florida Gulf Coast. Yep. Dump City.
Real fun to watch that year. Cinderella.
A little high-low action and too strong. Spartans come out of there with it. That's Cunningham. Malik Moore in traffic and had that shot bothered. There's a couple of players hit the deck.
Noko didn't block it, but he definitely influenced it because he knew Landry Noko was down there and threw it up way short. That's the rim protector. That's what Noko and Sinjite can give you. Wide open, nobody on defense. And Noko might have got a piece of it, but he influenced it more than he blocked it. Those are the two rim protectors, Sinjite and Landry Noko. They're going to pay big dividends for Coach Brownell by being so active around the rim.
And Nate, we talked about the rule changes. Here we are nearly 12 minutes in. Two combined fouls between these two teams so far, both against the Spartans. That last one, by the way, on Malik Moore. The freedom of movement in full effect tonight. Hudson the hot hand, now with nine to lead all scorers.
Nice quick shot. He just stretches the defense by just drifting down to the baseline. And they know he's hit a couple. Keep giving him the rock.
Lead has reached double digits for the first time, 23-12.
It's funny, after you score, you play so much better defense. Just get after it a little bit.
Well, that's something Brad Brunell's talked about for years here. There's an answer from the left wing by Deion Holmes. I'm going to say that's a long two. His foot was on the line. That'll make it 23-14.
That's one they're going to review after Remy Stein just told Eddie Payne we'll look at it.
Grantham comes up short. Two on three, fast break. Holmes has a scorer's mentality, the floater back iron. And a foul over the back.
And with the new rules, now they can go look at it the next dead ball.
Timeout on the floor as we step aside.
Get the call right. The problem that some coaches and fans might have is, well, it's going to slow the game down. Well, if you do it efficiently, it's not going to slow the game down.
Well, that was a big concern before the season started, that with all the additional fouls called, that you would see longer games. Offensive foul here on the moving screen. Well, Sidibe picks up his first.
And that last time out, Ramey Steins went over on that last three and took about 10 seconds, looked at it, put two fingers up in the air, done. It's a two-point shot. So it can be done efficiently. You just have to have an effort to do that.
Baseline jumper, nothing but net by Cuthbertson. He now has five on 2 of 4 from the field. Grantham trying to answer. Rebounded by Blossom Game. And a foul inside.
It's funny, a Cuthbertson last shot. Last week when I was here to do the Clemson game against Texas Southern, I went over to watch Upstate practice. And at least 7-8 times during the practice, Coach Payne said, Josh, you've been here before. You know how to do this. Trying to make a point to the freshman, you yell at one kid and everybody else listens. But he is one of the few people that has a little experience on this team.
Outside to Holmes for three. And the Tigers red hot from distance. 6 out of 10 to start this one.
How many times have you said that over the years? Red hot from distance.
Well, you said it a bunch so far this season.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. A great game in Minnesota shooting a few people.
Holmes can't connect. Grantham leading the fast break. And Holmes an open look. Why not?
Consecutive threes give you confidence. They have hit a bunch of threes. It's all confidence. If you believe you can make the shot, you're going to make it. Nobody covers him. Watch this. Kicks it out to him. Okay, well, maybe I'll cover him. Nope, too late. It's gone. You can't give people open threes.
Holmes uncontested. A nice finger roll. 29-18, the score. Under 6 to play.
Hey, listen to me. No space on the screens. He went around the screen. There was no help. Holmes took it all the way to the bucket.
Nate, at some point, do you consider getting out of the matchup zone? Alley-oop attempt to Blossom Game. Can't corral it. That's what they do. I understand it.
At this point in the game, if there's this much time left in the game, maybe, but not in the half, I think you can change the way you play it and your coverages, which I'm sure they're capable of doing.
Holmes, the crossover, deadly. And the end one opportunity. Now, what an addition he has been to Brad Brunell's team this year, the transfer from San Francisco, replacing Rod Hall. And Nate, this is one of the things they really like about his skill set, more offensive-minded.
Yeah, great change of pace there. He looked like he was going to pull it up and set up. Teams don't set up anymore. They attack in transition. Once again, you don't have to play against the matchup. And Holmes does a good job of trying to get a three-point play out of it. Remember, he started 2 for 9 in threes this season. Not good at all. He just made consecutive threes from that right wing. And on top of everything else, he's turned it over a grand total of 5 times all year.
Pretty impressive.
It's not as good as Jordan Roper, but it's pretty good.
Young Holmes now with 2 personals for the Spartans. You trail it by 14.
Any coach will tell you you've got to value the rock. If you don't value the possession and turn it over needlessly, it kills you. That man's team is taking care of the basketball this year.
4th turnover the first half for the Spartans. And the Tigers in control. And we'll see them a couple of times in the next few weeks.
Yep.
Wofford, Presbyterian, South Carolina. A very interesting game that'll be played here at Greenville.
Both teams playing better. Another one.
Home short this time. Cunningham with the rebound. Wild shot in the paint. Whittington the miss. Skyhook. Schulte with the basket.
Whittington got the ball, and Sidibe had to go out and cover him, so he figures your big man's going to come that far out, I'm going to take him on the dribble. Just didn't make the shot, but Schulte right place, right time.
Lead is back to 12, approaching 4 minutes remaining in our first half. Avery Holmes fouled before the shot.
There's the new rule right there. Any freedom of movement that is hindered by a bump is this year called a foul, at least early in the season. We'll see when it gets a conference play.
Well, that's something else to watch, right? To see if all this continue into January.
Yep.
Because they've tried this before, and it really didn't.
Supposed to. And the supervisors say they'll do it, or they'll enforce it with their officials. We'll see. But there hasn't been the parade to the foul line in a lot of, in any of the games I've done so far.
Yeah, same
some
for me.
I've watched a few on TV. They're just they're hard to watch. And there's 60 free throws being taken.
Holmes, the sweet dish. And Jete missed the slam. But he'll shoot a pair of free throws.
If Avery Holmes can give you the three-point shooting, the transition opportunities and passes like that, that's the point. That's why
at some point in time,
it's definitely contagious.
Yeah.
It really is. When the team is shooting horrendously and you come in, there's a little heat on you to shoot better. When the team is shooting well, hey, I'm part of this team. I wear the orange, too. I can do my thing. And any playing time they can get out of this very highly touted freshman coming in here is just going to add to his capability when they need him in ACC games. They got three very capable guys in the backcourt. They can mix and match them. And Grantham at 6'8 can be that huge two-guard to see over zones and things like that to help him out, help them out.
Jete missed a pair of free throws. 10 to shoot. And a foul will be called against the Spartans. Oh, no, a timeout. Excuse me. My apologies. So with 11 seconds remaining on the shot clock, remember this year, too, Eddie Payne.
They've won it in the past. They had a lot of talent last year and lost Ty Green at 20 points a game as player of the year. But they can do it again in that league. He's got to get him ready for that.
Right. Three to shoot. Moore forces one. In and out. Jete the board.
That break. That was halfway down.
Tigers with a 12-point lead, approaching 3 minutes to play. Roper an open look. And the lefty strokes it again. Jordan Roper with nine.
But when you keep the ball moving, the defense has to slide a little bit, and they just couldn't get back.
Here's a steal. Grantham. And the rejection at the rim. Boy, that one came out of nowhere.
That's why everybody else has to hustle back. There's only two white jerseys down there thinking he had a layup or a dunk. That will be on the clip cut-up tomorrow, no question. Whether they win or lose.
Spot outside to Moore. Comes up short. Holmes clears. Weaving his way coast to coast. And the finish. Avery Holmes with 11.
Nobody stopped the basketball. If nobody stops the basketball, keep going until somebody stops you. They didn't. Holmes took it right to the rim. On the other side, Coach Payne's going to say, hey, boys, we got to stop the basketball.
Largest lead, call it 17. Deion Holmes the other way, nearly lost it.
I got it.
Back, throws it away.
Oh, missed. One hand. Always catch the ball with two hands, boy. I caught it with one, I missed.
Fundamentally not sound that time.
Absolutely.
By the coach, Nate Ross.
It's a little over my head on the bench.
Story of my life.
I think I hurt my shoulder.
And USC Upstate going to utilize another timeout. So perhaps coming unglued these last...
It's a little different. It's a little getting used to. And you never get used to not having your home. But it is what it is. And they're going to have a phenomenal home next year and way down the road.
And the interesting aspect of this venue, Clemson playing its home games here, it does have a postseason feel to it with the size and the sight lines behind the backboard. Grantham. Stop and pop. Too strong. Noko puts it back up and in.
And didn't put it on the floor.
You like that?
Buchanan, a big guy there, just caught him, went right back up it. Out quick the defender. Landry Noko, excellent play.
Open shot and conversion by Josh Cutherson, who now has seven.
No matter what the score, you know if you wear a white jersey says Clemson on, you better play defense. And you better get back in transition.
No look dish, Noko, and cannot connect. Working hard on the glass, gets it back. Outside Roper, that's his shot. Comes up short, gets it back himself.
Nobody knows where it's going better than the guy who just shot it. Nobody sealed him out, he followed his shot. It's two offensive rebounds in this possession, one by Noko, one by Roper. You can't give a team three opportunities, they're probably going to get you.
Under a minute to play in a fast-moving first half. Noko back to work. Eight to shoot. Grantham. Way off. And the Spartans can play for the final shot.
I was just about to say, 10 seconds on the shot clock, nobody panicked. Mr. Grantham did a bit.
Checked out a 2-second differential between the game clock and the shot clock. Shot clock this season at 30 seconds, no longer at 35.
Yep. And the NCAA is not trying to be politically correct. They're not going to go from 35 to 24. They're just not going to do that. They will eventually.
I was campaigning for that. Nobody listened
to me. Oh, I agree. But they're never going to make that drastic of a change. But I give this 30 a couple years, and they'll move to 24.
Smith, foot was on the line, rebounded by Roper. 4 seconds. Directing traffic. Hudson's had the hot hand. And can't connect. Spartans stay in their matchup zone.
Coach has harped on moving the ball and moving bodies. Make the zone, make a mistake.
And down low, the foul on the floor.
We got Landry Noko and Marvin Smith at 6'6 playing him or trying to play him. Just no way he can guard him. He had to foul him.
But a first half that saw Clemson commit just one personal foul. We don't see that too often.
No, that's good. The key to playing good defense is doing it without fouling. And that's as good as you can get.
Smith the rebound on the Grantham miss.
Hold a team in the 20s and only foul them one time. That's impressive. And hold them under a decent shooting percentage.
And Spartan shot just 35% in the first 20. 2 of 8 from distance. It'll stay with Upstate here.
You know, it is a good challenge for Noko and Sidibe against Buchanan, because in the ACC, if a kid's hurting him inside, they're going to double him. But I don't think Coach Brennell, because of the score, he wants to see what his guys can do one-on-one in the post and see if they can guard.
Holmes the quick hands. That's Holmes versus Holmes.
You know, they talked about Holmes a lot in practice today, the one with the black shirt. You got to guard him. He's the key to this offense. If you can slow him down, you can slow the Spartans down. And so far, they've done a good job. He's only been in single digits once this year. It was the first game of the year against Texas A&M. He's in single digits so far tonight.
Personal win against Jaron Blossom game, his first.
You can see, even in double teams, they showed him. He'd average 3,000 points, not average, scored 3,000 points in high school. He had games of 60 and 61 in high school.
Cutlass in the miss. Saved by Buchanan, but out of bounds to Brad Brownell. Yeah, if you could score that kind of volume and that kind of consistency, that's going to translate no matter where you go.
That was a 2A high school, but I don't care where you're scoring. Right. 61 is 61. What a great quote from Coach Eddie Payne said, it's like when you shoot 59 on the golf course. They don't say it was an easy golf course. You shot 59.
And Deion Holmes, one of just two players in the history of South Carolina high school basketball to score over 3,000 points. Roper, feed Blossom game. And a foul, a block, he called against the Spartans.
It's a good possession, ended up with the foul on Blossom. But they got the ball to the top, they swung it back around. You can see the defense is running out to him, and you just can't body up like that.
Second personal against Marvin Smith.
You can see they're getting out on shooters now. They talked about that at halftime.
2 minutes into the second half, Tigers a commanding lead.
What this defense does is it lures you into just passing and not moving the ball. You got to move the ball and the bodies.
Clemson 0 for its first two from bonus land so far. The first 2 minutes of our second half, Holmes gets it back and the bounce.
That's all because Landry Noko kept it alive with the effort on the offensive tip. Up at Minnesota, he kind of stopped on a play, and it was a play to turn the game at the end. I'm sure he learned from that. That was a great effort play.
Cunningham. Cutherson. Strong defense, Tigers remaining in their man-to-man.
You know what's not happening? Upstate is not driving by anybody with the dribble. You just don't go by the Clemson Tigers on the dribble. Nice roll there for the best shooter on this basketball team.
That rim must be soft on that end. That's the second time we've seen that kind of bounce.
Yep.
Nate, let me ask you this as well. We saw Clemson red hot from three-point range in the first 20. If you're Brad Brunell, do you tell your team, hey, that's fool's gold. Let's actually run our offense here.
Well, yeah, you got to do that because you're not going to – if you live by that, eventually, if you get a little cold, the momentum switches to the other team. And in a conference game or in a closer game, it can be a big factor. And the best three-point shot you can get is inside out. Contract that defense and kick it out to open shooters. But what they're doing now, they're not moving their bodies. They're moving the ball. You got to fake a pass. You got to move bodies. And you can screen against the zone.
Two personals now against Cunningham.
Effectively in the first half. Look out.
And Blossom game in traffic.
They're hitting his face, too.
Appears to be okay. And Brad Brunell tells his team to slow it down here.
What call is set here.
Nice screen for Roper. Swing it around the horn. Inside out. You caught it. Back iron for Roper. Noko, the putback. And out of bounds to the Spartans.
That's good effort on the offensive glass. So you're bigger, you're longer. Go play volleyball with it. They did. They just couldn't get the tip. There's the first shot. Watch. Noko gets a hand on it to keep it alive and tries to put another one up. It's slapped out of bounds by Noko. It went up a third time.
Lead is 15. 4 minutes in. Nearly stolen. And the runners miss. Noko the rebound.
First time they've helped out in the post. Grantham got a hand on it.
A slow start offensively in our final 20 minutes for both sides. Lawson game for three. He's been hitting that shot this year, 42% for bonus land coming in, and Blossom game now with nine.
Went from the right corner all the way around to the left corner, and the defense just can't move that fast. You can't physically move as fast as the ball can be passed.
Spahn will feed the post. Schulte down low.
When you out quick Jaron Blossom game, you're pretty good.
Yeah.
That's what he did right there.
Lead is back to 16. Grantham.
He looked up to the heaven like finally. In practice today, he didn't make a lot of threes. Just made that one, though.
Made his first 5 3-point attempts against. It wasn't Texas Southern. It was UTSA. And he makes his first one here tonight.
ACC Championship.
And that game's already been announced as a sellout, one
That's
versus
great.
10.
I don't think they can get beat. I think they attack you so many different ways. Their quarterback is so adept at throwing and running. And they got a seriously good defense.
Cuthbertson.
North Carolina lost to South Carolina, had a bad year. First game of the year and hadn't lost since.
Right.
But that'll be a fun game. Selling out, it's always fun. And then it's if they stay where they are, and I think they will, it's going to the top four. But a four-court action by Upstate now.
Lead is 17. Clemson basketball. Tigers in their white home uniforms. USC Upstate, the black road units. First ever matchup between these two teams. Not even separated by 50 miles.
See Roper, when he fakes the pass, the defense reacts to it. They have to. You got to react to that little orange thing. Everybody does.
Six to shoot. DeVoe to Roper. He's got to hurry. And the shot clock violation. Good defense by the Spartans.
Much more active defensively, and Clemson moved the ball. They didn't move bodies that time. They didn't screen anybody. Always drives you nuts as a coach when you know they talked about that during timeout. They heard, but they did not listen.
Schulte down low, gives it to Blossom game. And the save to DeVoe, too strong.
DeVoe wanted to give it right back to Jaron Blossom game, but he kind of mishandled it, and then it became a series of mistakes.
Cuthbertson top of the key, now to Thomas. Cuthbertson in to shoot. Cuthbertson, nice drive.
First time all night that the Tigers got beat off the dribble. Cuthbertson went right by. Gabe DeVoe that time.
And double figures with 11, Josh Cuthbertson.
And now a screen in the zone. That's better, and you get a good shot.
Great pump fake. And a chance for two at the free throw line.
In the first half, Jaron Bloss game showed us a whole lot. Took off in transition, got a dunk. Had a block shot. Showed his athleticism, hit some threes. This is the other part of his game. He's got the strength to go inside, get hammered, still get the shot off. And he got grabbed pretty good on both arms, so no chance to make it. But he's capable of doing a lot of different things on a basketball court. And watch the way he shoots free throws. NBA guys do that. He doesn't bend his knees because he's so strong from the up in the upper body. He doesn't have to. Young kids got to use your legs to shoot. He doesn't.
Great story for Jaron Blossom game as well. Suffered a compound leg fracture, had a redshirt a season. There was thoughts of whether or not he could ever return to his highest level again. And after recovering from all of that, potentially an all-ACC player this season, you're getting a glimpse of that tonight.
That's a credit to him with just stick-to-itiveness. He's just hanging in there. And a great medical staff, of course. But you got to have a lot of want-to, and he's got that.
But Nate, that was one of those leg injuries where the bone basically broke the skin.
Yep.
It was devastating in every sense of the word.
And then had a second surgery because something wasn't healing right. So that's why he lost that 1 year.
Dave DeVoe. Back iron.
That's good ball movement. Just missed the shot. That's really good ball movement. Unselfish, find the open play.
Thomas defended by Hudson. Inside out, an open look from distance. And the rebound cleared by Jete.
Coach Cornell is going to call set here.
Spartans remain in that 2-3 matchup zone.
Yeah, they're not going to come out of it maybe till an 8-minute timeout. Nice pass.
DeVoe down low will shoot a pair.
The problem of playing against this matchup, it's like we just talked about football. It's like a read option. You got to read and react, but in football, you do it once. And either you hand off or you don't. In basketball, you got to do it 7-8 times within the possession.
Right.
To read and react. And it's tough to do when you don't see this kind of defense. Now, they're going to play Syracuse, but Syracuse is not, it's a zone, but it's not a matchup as much. It's just a bunch of long bodies out there in a 2-3 zone. So it's different.
Legend Roberton checks in for the first time of his Clemson career. Was waiting to be officially cleared. And now that he is, his first minutes as a Clemson Tiger.
Philip Sykes said he got a text today while he was sitting here that he's eligible. He said, nobody told me. Evidently they did.
Junior college transfer. And another one of those bigs down low that can bang once conference play gets underway.
Phenomenal athlete who's learning to play the game from England, but works very hard at it.
Contested shot. And saved to the Tigers.
And you know he's got to be jacked up. First time on the court for the Tigers.
Down low to Smith. The up and under and the finish.
Now here's a second front line that has not played together, obviously, because he's just eligible. But you get Smith and Robertson together, that's a nice little backup pair.
Here's a steal.
Oh, they want to give him the ball. Oh, they deflected. There it was.
Hudson with a miss. Roper with the rebound.
You know, everybody on that Clemson team wants 00 to get the rock. He's worked hard in practice.
Approaching 11 minutes to play. Roberton, 00 in white. Back to Hudson. And the rebound for USC Upstate. Here comes Spahn. Outside of Thomas, count it.
You can have good things happen to you. That's 6 of the 15 in the top 24 in the country. Full court press changing up the D. Coach Payne's going to make a run here when he gets the single digits. And you got to wait your time and try to make a run and try to get this W.
10 to shoot for Jordan Roper. Tigers have led from the onset. Holmes in traffic and a strong finish at the rim. Well, this guy's tough. You talk about Miami, if you didn't know any better, he's got the body type of an Angel Rodriguez. Yep. And the scoring is starting to come as well.
Yeah, it's a Rod Hall kind of body. I mean, that's the kind of bodies you need to play in the backcourt in the ACC. But that was a good, quick move.
Down low, the rejection, and the whistle. Buchanan back to the stripe, 64% this season, and Buchanan's had himself a pretty good start this evening. 4 for 4 from the field, 8 points. And a rebound to boot.
He's going to get it in tight, and you don't miss, keep throwing to him.
Well, he's a big body down low.
250 pounds, got a nice stroke from the free throw line as well. Played a lot more last year than he did this year. I don't know if he's in the doghouse or not, but he's working his way out of it pretty quick.
Two for two.
That's as good a look in a free throw as you're going to see for a kid that big. Usually big guys don't have good free throw percentage. Or free throw motion, I should say. It's full court.
Roper will draw the double team with Smith and Moore. And a timeout called by the Tigers.
Good job by Upstate. They let him catch it where they wanted him to catch it, in the corner. When he turned his back to the rest of the court, they doubled him and forced him to call a timeout. But he had the presence of mind to do that.
And we mentioned earlier, Clemson is somewhat road weary right now. Three straight games on neutral courts, including a road trip to Vegas and another one to Minnesota earlier this week as part of the ACT Big Ten Challenge. And so grab some dead legs tonight, although you can tell by the fast start, I suppose.
No, but Coach told us they got home at 5 o'clock in the morning.
That's tough.
Minnesota trip and went 8 o'clock classes. I mean, that's hard to do. And the Vegas trip before that, and I didn't know, Phillip Sykes was telling me it snowed 8 inches when it got to Minnesota.
Right. It had de-ice.
So all that stuff takes its toll. I mean, they are young kids, but still. Everybody watches them on the court. They're going to college too, folks. They're going to class every day. That's another tough thing. They're 45 minutes away from campus. It's not like, you know, get out of class, go to your dorm, go eat a pregame meal, and then play a home game.
Right.
You got to get on the bus and drive out.
Tigers having some problems inbounding the basketball against that full court pressure. They'll finally work it into the front court.
The theory is when you screen the top of the zone, the next man has to play, or if he doesn't, you do that.
Holmes, another answer from distance. Avery Holmes with 18 points tonight.
When you screen the top man on zone, if the other guard doesn't come over, you get that Avery Holmes shot. If he does, you rotate the basketball.
7 of 9 from the field, 3 of 4 from bonus land for Avery Holmes. Transfer from USF. Of course, you say that on the East Coast, most people assume it's South Florida.
Exactly.
When actually it's San Francisco. I do want to point that out.
And that time, same principle, screen the zone, and then Roper just finds his way into the middle. When you screen the top of a 2-3 with the bodies that Clemson has, like Noko and Sidy Jatte, it's tough to get around the screen, so you have a distinct advantage.
Marvin Smith picks up his third personal. Josh Smith, the turnaround. Free throw line extended.
That is his shot. He's really good from there, great rhythm. Sometimes he likes to get behind that three line a little bit too much, in my opinion. But he's tough in 15, 17 feet. Nice move.
You can in the spin, but an air ball.
I didn't think he had that kind of quicks. That was impressive.
And Moore from distance. Malik Moore the basket, now with 6. And the lead is back to 20. If you're just joining us, Tigers have pretty much led from the get-go. Early 10-0 run created the initial separation. And then Clemson red hot from behind the three-point arc. Noko outside to DeVoe, and the hot shooting continues. Gabe DeVoe with 5.
We talked about Landry Nocco, with all the skills he has, he's a really good passer for a big man as well. He knows where his teammate is and he finds him in a shooting pocket. That's an underrated skill that people don't appreciate with him, I think.
More of the hoop. USC Upstate shooting 50% from the field here in the second half. Tigers also at 8 of 16 from the floor. And Josh Smith says, thank you very much, coach.
See, I told you he was a good three-point
There's
shooter.
Your answer right there. Minnesota and tonight against USC Upstate.
I don't care who you're playing. When you make them from behind that line at that kind of a clip, the rest of the coaches in this league will say, maybe you better guard some shooters for the Tigers.
And what was that you told me in the first half? This isn't your
grandfather's Clemson offense.
Yeah. In the paint, Buchanan, too strong. Roberton clears. So now the box score for the first time.
Defense, he didn't foul and he got the rebound. He's a big body. 7 foot, 250 pounds. That's, I think, 22 stone or whatever in England. I don't know.
Well, he's the first player from England to ink with the Tigers since Alou Babalola back in 2001. They were waiting for him to be cleared. Finally, they got the news earlier today.
He's got a rebound. Now you got to give him a point or two.
Setting up down low, calling for the alley-oop. He gets it and cannot connect.
His brain's probably going a million miles an hour. He waited for the opportunity and found out today. Good for him.
Whittington the basket. And the lead is back to 22, under 7 minutes to play.
You know, if he and Josh Smith, we were talking about it during the break, that gives Clemson some serious depth in the post.
Well, plus City Chate and Landry Nocco.
Oh, yeah.
And Roberton in the paint and the finish.
There it is. First basket as a Clemson Tiger. Pretty adept move there. A little jump hook. That's an unstoppable shot. It's all about getting position before the ball comes. And he got great deep position at a two-footer.
Mike Cunningham, the deep three on the baseline. He now has 11 points. First points of his Clemson career right here.
2 feet in the paint, little jump hook. With his size, that's unstoppable. I don't care who you're playing against. That shot cannot be blocked. But inside that restricted area and just got a little two-footer.
Holmes. Roberton, the jam. And with authority that time, Nate.
Absolutely. He waited. He knew the pass was coming. Good hands, good finish. Looks like he's been out there for years.
He's an old pro.
That's exactly right. I know every coach on that Clemson bench is happy to see him participate.
In traffic, a nice finish by Marvin Smith. Well, Mike Winecki works with the Clemson bigs. He's got to be very pleased with this most recent development. A, that he's now eligible to play.
Sure.
B, 4 quick points off the bench.
And any points off the bench just adds to the basketball team's confidence and adds to the depth.
Outside, Grantham too strong. Roberton's active too. We've seen him try to swat a couple of shots.
He doesn't post up every second they have the ball. He's smart about it. A lot of guys post up every second the ball's on the offensive end. That's just not smart.
And Holmes will shoot a pair.
Going to count, but he had a nice tip there. He's an active, athletic 7-footer. They don't come along too often.
What do you think about some of the bigs in Clemson history over the years, going all the way back to Tre Rollins, Eldon Campbell, Dale Davis, Sherron Wright, first round draft pick.
Yep. He's going to be a good one. He just has he's got a great work ethic too, but you learn from that because they're going to face a lot of adverse conditions the rest of the season.
Holmes now with 19.
You know, I was thinking about this driving up here. When you think of Clemson over the years, the first thing that doesn't come to your mind is, boy, they can really shoot the basketball. But that's the case this year.
Have you seen enough to convince yourself that that's changing?
Yeah. Oh, no question about it. They're a good shooting team who on nights can be an excellent shooting team. First of all, they don't take bad shots. They take good shots, and they have the skill level to make them. And when you get the production inside and the good passers, they can kick it back out. That's a great combination. And they'll get transition buckets, too, to up their percentage because they're pushing it more than they ever have.
A new career high in a Clemson uniform for Holmes with 20. Hudson in traffic. Can't connect. Rebound to USC Upstate. That's Whittington. And has his pocket pick, Hudson. 11 points for the freshman, Ty Hudson.
You know what you love? He took maybe an ill-advised shot, didn't hang his head, got it right back on defense and laid it in. The freshmen don't do that, Roy. That's a great asset.
Robert in the rebound and tapped out of bounds, it'll stay with the Tigers.
0-2.
Yeah, that's right.
Always.
And I'll blame that on you.
Well, of course. Still a 2-3 matchup. It just starts out as a 1-1-3. Upstate, we're moving hand guys off. Communicating is the key to this.
Robert in down low to Smith. 7 to shoot and a turnover.
When the 7-footer dives on the floor, that's a great thing. The great Pat Riley said basketball games are won when the ball's in the air and when it's on the floor. He didn't reach for it. He dove on the floor to try to get it. Remember, this kid has not played a basketball game for Clemson yet. He's played a year in junior college.
Spartans with 2 players in double figures tonight. Buchanan with 10, Cuthbertson with 11. Free throws coming up here for USC Upstate.
Cunningham is another freshman on this basketball team. Went to my rival high school, Duval High School in Oxon Hill, Maryland. I went to Suitland High School. We hated each other. Of course, his father probably wasn't born when I played at Suitland High School, let alone him. Pretty talented kid, almost 20 points a game in high school.
Just a 50% free throw shooter this season. And 1 of 2 at the stripe here. Hudson with a rebound. Well, if you look at the box score tomorrow, perhaps Clemson fans will be impressed with Roberton's 4 points and a couple of boards. Yep. But, Nate, his footwork, his hustle, and his overall athleticism has really stood out to me.
There's no question. That's his shot. That is Josh Smith's shot. Mix in a 3 once in a while, but he's really good from 15 to 17. No, Robertson's impressive. He's an impressive athlete.
3-on-1. Roper. Roberton.
He had Josh Smith for a layup, but he wanted to give it to the big man. I love that. You know, and he hasn't played in a game. Yeah, he's practiced. He doesn't look really winded. Watch this. Coming right at you. He's got Josh Smith on the left of the picture, but he wants to give it to legend. What a great first name. You think you're a legend in your own mind? He is a legend.
Roberton at the stripe.
3 years to be in the weight room. 3 years to work.
Well, the physique's pretty impressive, though, right?
Oh, yeah.
How about this stat? Given to me by legendary statistician Sam Blackman. Clemson tonight, more steals than fouls. That's a good night.
That's a great night.
7 steals, 4 personals.
Coach Brownell will love that. He'll talk about the defense from London, England. Somebody went in a little too quick. And now you can go up to Mr. Robert and say, okay, you're playing now. Work on your free throws. And they will. It's just a different mentality. He didn't know when or if the NCAA was going to clear him. They did. And now he's a 100% member of this team.
10 to shoot. Outside to Thomas. A misfire. Ty Hudson working against a double team will back it out. And the Tigers here, Nate, probably content to milk some clock. And they'll bring in some of their walk-ons in the process. Lyles Davis checks in for the first time, as does Riley McGillen.
Talked to Riley McGillen at shoot-around. His dad, a good friend. Marty McGillen's a coach, assistant coach at Winthrop. I said, Riley, you're leading the nation in threes. You haven't missed. He's two
perfect
for two. Hit one in Minnesota. Great kid. Dad's been a good friend for many, many years.
That's 44 in white on your screen. Smith, the up and under attempt. And Roberton came down awkwardly on that left knee, grabbing it. We'll keep action going on the other end of the floor. Basket is made, but Roberton is still down in the paint.
You can see the motion he just made, like it moved a funny way.
Now, Nate, like you said, hopefully just hyperextended it. Nothing more than a sprain, but of course, the doctors will determine that.
Sure.
Back to live action. Jete down low and the foul inside.
Mr. Roberton will be living in an ice pack tonight. No question about it, especially on the 45-minute trip back to campus. You can see one thing is you can see the look on his face. He was pained at first. He looks a little more relaxed. That's a good thing. And the ice pack will be on his knee momentarily, I would bet.
Tigers in the bonus, approaching a minute to play. And with this win, Clemson improved to 5-2. USC Upstate will fall to 1-8. Open look from distance. Down it goes for Tompkins.
Doesn't get any easier for USC Upstate. That's good. East Carolina face Jeff Lebo's very athletic basketball team in 2 days.
Davis splits the double team nicely.
Everybody in the bench went to Riley McGillen to shoot that.
And ahead to Moore with the finish.
These guys that aren't on scholarship work just as hard, or maybe even harder. They got to learn everybody else's offense in a day. Always fascinated me. Your kids can't learn your offense, but you can take five guys who don't play a lot and teach them the other team's offense in 15 minutes. He anticipate, get it, and most importantly, Malik Moore finish it, and he did.
Well, Lyles Davis at the stripe, a three-time team captain at James Island Charter High School. He led his team to a region championship. And how about this? Nate was also featured on the scorecard today, given to fans making their way inside.
Impressive.
Bonsa Coors Wellness
Showing
Arena.
Showing off the guns.
Well, it is the end of a 20-point victory, it sounds like, doesn't it?
Yep. Tigers did everything well tonight. Shot the ball well, played good defense, did not foul in their aggressive defense, and they played man-to-man the entire 40 minutes, and that's what they're going to do more times than not. It's just the way Coach Brownell coaches. And as a coach, maybe took two ill-advised shots, maybe three the whole night, but took really good shots. When you do that, you're going to make a bunch.
Jete clear, shot clock is off, and that'll just about do it. Now the Tigers connect on 13 three-pointers. After connecting for 14 against Minnesota, first time in school history, that's happened. And a comfortable victory here tonight in Greenville, final score 7.